Welcome to the Glam Cam. I'm Rachel Barenbaum, author of A Bend in the Stars. And today I am here with author extraordinaire Kelly Jo Ford, whose debut, Crooked Hallelujah, just dropped. It was so, so, so good. I loved it. Kelly, tell us, what is your book about?
Thank you so much, Rachel. My book is about a mixed blood Cherokee mother and daughter who leave Eastern Oklahoma's Indian country looking for a better life. And that takes them to North Texas during the oil bust of the 1980s. And it's really a book about mothers and daughters.
How personal is the story in Crooked Hallelujah?
It's the characters and the plot are fictional, but, you know, a lot of the bones of the story are similar to my upbringing. As I mentioned, I grew up in a family of strong women, and at different times when I was a little girl, there were four generations of women in our household. So I was born in Tahlequah, the capital of the Cherokee Nation, and I moved to North Texas. So you can kind of look and see waves of the story where it's like, oh yeah, that's very similar to my background. But so I sort of took that inspiration as a jumping off point and created fictional characters and tornadoes and, you know, things like that.
Fun things like that.
Yeah.
I really read this book as a story of mothers and daughters. Can you talk about that?
That's what it is to me too. It's nice to hear you say that. It is, you know, I started writing, the first story that I wrote in the book was about Justine. And then it became clear that if I was going to write her story, I was also writing her daughter's story. But you can't really tell her daughter's story without telling the grandmother's story, you know? And so it just really, to me, like, was about the relationships of these women to each other over the generations and how it changes, and but yet how they remain there for one another in love.
There's also really a pull between religion and faith and the desire to leave that all behind. Can you talk about that?
Something that I think that the main character, Justine, carries with her throughout the novel. You see it from the very opening story until kind of the last moments you spend with her in the book. And I think that was a big inspiration for me. I'm interested in faith and questions of faith in both believers and non-believers. And so that was something that really, like, I think I carried with me in different ways in each story or chapter in the book.
What do you want readers to take away from Crooked Hallelujah?
That's a really good question. And I'm not sure that I have a good answer, but I think that what's important to me in the book are the relationships between the women. And I feel like you see a fierce love and connection despite hardships or despite, you know, flaws a character may have. You see that they're going to fight for one another no matter what. And so when I think about the characters of the book, that's what I want. That's what I take away from them. And so I hope people see that. And I also hope they see moments of joy and connection, because, you know, there's a lot of struggle in the book. But I think in those characters' relationships to one another is where there is joy and goodness.
What was the hardest part to write?
There were times when the youngest character, Renee, is witnessing violence. That was difficult. There were times that was difficult to write, just in terms of, like, figuring out what to do on that level. Figuring out where to start the book was a challenge that I struggled with for years, really, because I had so much story. And so figuring out where to start it was a challenge.
Can you talk about the power of women? I just kept thinking when I was reading this book, I was like, the power of women, the power of women. And so I don't know how else to ask it, because that's the phrase that was in my head.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I think this is a book about powerful women who do whatever they need to do to try to make a better path. And they're for in this case, were their daughters. And they're doing that with the information they have on hand in the situation that they're in. And that's something that I feel like I see women all around me doing, you know, that's a drive to do, like, your life's work. And if you have children, to try to make a better path. Some of the characters don't have the opportunity to know what their life's work because their life's work is survival. But eventually, you know, in generations, perhaps that changes. And I think you see that in this book too.
Do you have a dream for Crooked Hallelujah? Something that you want the book to do now that it's out in the world?
When I think about what I want for Crooked Hallelujah, I feel like I want people, like I really want people from back home to read it and feel like they, that I captured a place, you know, and a people, perhaps. A people that's sort of like high-minded. I don't think that I can capture a people, but I want to feel like that people from back home can read it and feel like, yeah, look at this.
Kelly, thank you so much for joining me today. As I said, I loved Crooked Hallelujah. May you sell many, many copies.
Thank you so much. You take care.